It is extra spicy and extra muddy, if you know what I mean. Hello, people of YouTube. So today we are going to be sipping the seas and talking about the Wayfair scandal. It is extra spicy and extra muddy, if you know what I mean. I loaded up my Caesar with some lime, a celery stick, some deep jerky, some pickles, and a little grilled cheese sandwich. I did make a video about this yesterday. However, I've been doing more research and some more stuff has come out regarding the scandal. So I figured, might as well make another one. I just want to say everything that I'm going to talk about today is alleged information at this moment in time. There hasn't been anything confirmed by any authorities. This is just all information that's floating around at the moment. Please do all your own research, check everything out, question what's going on, you know. Also, do not send any hate to any companies or people mentioned in the video. I do have some screenshots. I came with receipts. Yes, I did, honey. If you need to pause, feel free, pause. You can always look them up yourself. Most of these screenshots are online. So, if you don't know what the current Wayfair scandal is, it's about trafficking. Yes, like human trafficking. The other day, someone online had noticed there are some products on Wayfair that were identical to other products on Wayfair. And for whatever reason, these products were marked at an extremely, extremely high price and model name was different. So there are some cabinets that were in question. The Kyla cabinet is online for like 12 grand. There's a drilling shower curtain online for like 10 grand. A pillowcase, a Dipulous pillowcase online for 10 grand as well. And then there's also a pimento dinosaur picture set that is online. And that is listed for $30,000. And it's a set of 4 framed prints, like small prints. Definitely not worth 30 grand. Anyways, some of these products online that are marked for thousands and thousands of dollars are identical to other products on Wayfair that are marked online for anywhere from like $10 to $300. So this is what got people thinking, okay, that's kind of weird. Maybe it's a glitch in the system. Wayfair has already been involved in a scandal last year. In 2019, they were involved in a scandal. They signed a contract with ICE detention centers saying that they were going to be supplying ICE detention centers with some furniture and beds. As soon as that news broke out, it caused backlash on the internet. Lots of people were furious. They decided they didn't want to spend their money at Wayfair anymore. And a bunch of employees walked out on the job and quit right away. This particular person, I believe it was either someone on Twitter or someone on Reddit, who noticed that these products online were marked for an extremely high price, also remembered that the ICE detention centers have been guilty of losing over 1,500 children. I know that sounds crazy, but it's true. Because ICE and Wayfair have a contract together and a bunch of kids are going missing, this was making the Reddit user think more and more. Or the Twitter user, person on the internet, started looking up the names of these model numbers online and found that names of missing people and children were popping up. This started sparking the idea that Wayfair was potentially using its website to traffic human beings. What started solidifying the idea was employees coming forward and saying that while they allegedly worked for Wayfair, they were loading boxes that were marked ASAP into the truck. And these boxes were way heavier than they should have been. When they were marked ASAP, it meant that they had to be put on the truck as soon as possible and be loaded up fast. Once this information broke out, more people felt like this was a legitimate thing that was going on, and more people started looking into it. There was quite a few items on Wayfair that were extremely high priced for no good reason. Less than 24 hours after this post had gone viral, Newsweek had reached out to Wayfair and asked for an explanation on the pricing. Wayfair said the items are accurately priced. So this got people thinking, okay, that's kind of weird. Then someone copy-pasted the SKU from one of the extremely overpriced items on Wayfair and posted it into Yandex. Now, what is Yandex, you might wonder? Well, Yandex is a Russian search engine, similar to Pinterest, where you can type something in and pictures will pop up. Now, the files that pop up aren't fully large images. They are usually smaller images, like lower quality images, images that don't have any external links. You can't go to a website from this, but you can see a picture that's linked to a website. Click on that picture and that picture will take you to a link, if that makes sense. If you've ever used Pinterest, it's kind of like when you're searching up a recipe, you see a picture of something that looks delicious, you click on it, and then it takes you to someone's blog. So it's kind of like that. This particular Reddit user had decided to copy the SKU number off of Wayfair and paste it into the browser on Yandere. Now, Yandere is a search engine. It wasn't created to be a child trafficking site or a human trafficking website. However, it is owned by the Russians, created by the Russians, and all of the data collected from it is in control of the Russians. Because of that, there are allegations that pedophiles from North America are using Yandere as a form of communication because when they're using their IP scrambler, it's scrambling their IP address all over the US, so they can't be, it's really hard to track them. And then when they're searching up everything under a Russian search engine in like a private, on a private server, it's a little bit easier for them to get away with it because that's just one more thing that the US government struggles to access, right? So the way that Yandere works is that you have to have an SRC kind of tag on something in order for an image to take you to an external link, like a different website or a chat forum, blah, 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 blah. By typing in SRC USA, you're looking up for tags in the USA, if that makes sense. There's a lot of speculation that Yandere has been used for human trafficking. I'm not saying that is true, but I am saying that it is possible. Websites like Craigslist and Facebook have been used for human trafficking as well. This particular user types in SRC USA and then copy paste the code, the SKU code from one of the products found online and posted it into Yandere. When they did this, it popped up with a bunch of inappropriate pictures of little girls that are tagged in the US that have external links for forums and more information about their exact location, how to get in contact, and all that kind of stuff, which is really freaking creepy. Now, this could totally be a coincidence, but it seems kind of weird. Now, because some employees have come forward and said that they have loaded boxes that are extremely heavy and marked ASAP for Wayfair, a lot of people think that Wayfair is directly involved. Now, if you're going to be shipping humans across the country through Wayfair, there would have to be a lot of people involved. A human can only... My dog's just drinking water. A human can only be trapped in a small, confined space for about 5 hours max before they die. You can't drink my Caesar, buddy. Because of this information, I don't really think that people are being trafficked across the country via Wayfair. I think what a more logical solution is that Wayfair and Yandere are being used by pedophiles.
Oh my God! Oh Jesus!
Now I will explain. So like many companies like Amazon or Walmart even, Wayfair offers the option for third parties to sell. So every product that's being sold through Wayfair isn't necessarily a Wayfair product, if that makes sense. That gives me reason to believe, because it's unrealistic that humans are being trafficked across the country via shipping container and in a tiny closet-sized box. Even if they're drugged, they simply won't get enough oxygen and they will die. I think it's more likely that there are pedophiles that are on Wayfair as third-party sellers, selling identical, very popular products on Wayfair as a way to make a legal transaction. So if you're someone who owns their own business and you sell your products online through something like Amazon, that's a totally legal job. You can file taxes, you can get receipts and show proof of income. So I think that's a likely scenario for a reason why, or a reason how they could be potentially using Wayfair to make legal transactions. Now their products are $30,000, which is ridiculous, but maybe they're shipping them out. You know, a pillowcase? Who really cares about a pillowcase if it's only worth $10 and you're a pedophile who's buying a human being for $30,000? You could just take that pillowcase and like take it to the thrift store. These people could even be shipping these products so that there's like a FedEx receipt and shipping these products out, but still collecting the thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars while also using Yandere as a way to have basically like an online catalog. So with their SKU number, you can type in the SKU number on Yandere as I talked about earlier, because you can type the SKU number from Wayfair into this website and have it as USA blah 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 blah, it just shows you a bunch of photos, which in my mind is kind of like a catalog for pedophiles. Like, they're just browsing through, these are all girls in the USA that they can buy for this price. Like, that's kind of what's in my head. And then once they click the image that they like, that will take you to contact information and like some chat form on an alternate external link, and it bounces you to another website, bounces you to another website, bounces you to another website. So you're constantly getting bounced around. These pedophiles aren't stupid. These people who are purposely searching this kind of stuff out are the kind of people that have like IP scramblers and private servers and private networks that people can't hack. I might be wrong, but this wouldn't be the first time someone's used a legal company for black market purposes.
Right now at 5:30,
there have been drivers and like DoorDash delivery service drivers that have been caught trafficking drugs and not actually really selling anything. Like, they might do a few deliveries, but they're also driving around and selling drugs all day. So that's my theory. I think that pedophiles are using Wayfair as a way to collect a legal transaction. They're also using Wayfair as a way to communicate a SKU where pedophiles can go on this Russian search engine that has less chance of being watched by the US government because it's Russian owned and Russian operated. I think these pedophiles are using the SKU number, getting people to punch it into these websites so then they have a catalog. Because when you punch in the SKU number, there's like a bunch of photos of little girls that pop up, and it's actually quite gross. I'll show you screenshots of the dinosaur set SKU number matching up with search results for USA on Yandex. So yeah, pretty f***ed up. I'm scratching out all the faces of any minors involved in this video because A, I don't have anyone's permission to post. B, minors shouldn't be involved in this, but they are. Maybe it's not Wayfair. Like, I personally don't want to think that Wayfair is directly involved in this because that's really f***ed up. Maybe they are. I don't think so. I think the likely situation is that there's pedophiles who are third-party sellers on Wayfair using Wayfair as a way to make a legal transaction, taking the money, having it deposited in their bank account, and then offering their customers the chance to use a SKU number to look at a catalog and then pick what they really want. Maybe that's too far-fetched, but I think that's a little bit more of a likely situation versus Wayfair having people at the factories traffic people, put them in closets, tape up the closets, and then throw them in shipping containers, because you literally have to let these people out for like multiple hours at a time for them to be able to regain their oxygen. To be able to regain their oxygen level so that they are able to go back in the truck for another 5 hours. It's just not a likely situation. I think there'd be way too many deaths. But yeah, so that's my personal theory. I haven't seen anyone else come up with that theory yet that I know of. I feel like that's a more legitimate theory than Wayfair actually shipping people in containers. That's all the information that I have today. Thank you guys so much for hanging out again. I do have another video that has a little bit more information. Maybe it doesn't have more information. I don't really know.
I'm kind of retarded.
Have a great day, guys. I'm gonna give my dog the rest of this beef jerky. And I'll drink the rest of this quick. Okay, bye, guys. One thing I forgot to quickly mention while I was filming, the Kyla dresser, the shower curtain, the Dupuis pillowcase, the pimento dinosaur pictures, all of the really expensive items that are in question for this particular scandal. The shower curtain can no longer be found. The dinosaur pics can no longer be found either. I did find the pillowcases. They are still named the same names as they were earlier. However, instead of being $10,000 each, they're now like $40 each. Way more reasonable pricing. The Kyla dresser has now been renamed to the Elite dresser. Some of the stuff you can't find the original post on Wayfair anymore. Wayfair has allegedly been doing a lot of removal. Items that are in question and in the scandal, I think they're probably doing their own internal investigation. There's been someone who's claimed to have called the trafficking tip line, and they're allegedly opening up an investigation about the whole scandal. So we'll see what goes from here. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you have a great day, and I'll see you later. Bye.